This is the Wellington pub. This is probably the last place that I had a drink with Ray before his illness took him. Numerous times he came to visit me in Sheffield, and almost the first thing he would say to me is, where are we going for a proper pint of beer? He reckoned he couldn't get a good beer in Los Angeles and he couldn't get a good beer in London. So the first thing, let's go out and get a pint. Raymond John Cooper. I never knew him as Ray. He never called himself Ray, did he? Ray was actually, at that time, he was John Cooper, but I think he became Coops and then Stoops. All of us here all knew him as Stoops. It was only later on that he became Rockin' Raymond when he moved to London and he started working in the music business.
Gone is the pre-war smoke and grime, even though steelmaking is still at the heart of the city's heavy industry.
Sheffield was a dark northern industrial city. When Ray had left school, he'd become a commercial trainee at Thomas Ward's. One of the things that they'd done was teach him how to drive. I went down one Saturday morning for him to borrow a car from the carpool, and we set off.
Where are we? We're approaching London.
To go to Covent Garden, to go to the Middle Earth Club, to see Pink Floyd.
Before they had any hits.
Before they had any hits, yeah. And it was a great night.
Here comes another fucker.
Stoops was the first real hippie I ever met.
I mean, the house was the house that Stoops lived in, I lived in, and three or four other guys. The thing about living at that house on Abbeydale Road,
it was a bit of a tip.
Jim would say, look at the state of this place, it's a fucking tip. And it was.
It was quite common to see two or three of us with fur coats, sometimes with the arms cut off so we looked like Sonny and Cher. And I remember Stoops had a really small women's plastic jacket. Do you remember that?
Yeah.
With the arms up here.
There's more to Sheffield than can be discovered in one day, even with the help of refreshment and the friendly spirit of the local. After all, there are people who live in the city.
We used to come back from the Minerva pub, which was where we would hang out in the evenings, probably 11 o'clock at night, and then the party would start. I almost thought about it as the house of the three D's: drinks, drugs, and debauchery. And that's what it was like.
I could take double anything you could.
With Neil and I. Yeah, well, that might be some kind of akin.
Neil and Stoops discovered one milkman who on his round also delivered potatoes. and they used to follow the milkman around and take some of the bags of potatoes, liberate them, I think, with the word Stoops would use. He'd say, we've liberated some more potatoes, man.
I was fond of women at that time and had a lot of different girlfriends. Raymond seemed to have a different one every week. I mean, he was very popular with girls, you know.
A girlfriend and myself were sitting on the swings and this group of young people came along. Ray was one of them. There was much to-ing and fro-ing about my friend fancies your friend sort of teenage chat, and I ended up with Ray. You know, all the girls liked him. I did, my friend did. They were all quite envious when I was walking out with him.
We were very taken by the generosity of women. There would always be somebody who'd give us a bit of money.
We were absolutely blown away to see Joe Cocker, you know, Sheffield's own Man of Steel, playing at Woodstock with all these famous bands and musicians. And we'd seen him most recently playing at school dances.
Very knowledgeable about music in particular. One day we were all in the bar drinking and he came bursting into the bar and said, come and look at this, come and look at this. Fantastic band, this guy's got an amazing voice. And it was a band called Family. Stoops he'd been in there on his own watching them. And he couldn't wait to come out and tell us to get us all in there to watch it.
I remember Ray coming into the Minerva one night and saying, come on, we've got to go up to the art college on Salter Lane. there's this amazing band on, that's what they called, I don't know, let's go up there. So we went up there and it was Black Sabbath, and it was one of their very earliest gigs. But that was Ray, he didn't take life dead seriously. I mean, he was just out to have a load of fun. And he had an amazing capacity for fun, and for drink, and for other things, and for women.
We've laughed a lot thinking of the things that happened and the things that we all got up to. I know for sure if he was here now, we'd be laughing even more. He was just, anybody who knew him knows what a great guy he was and how much fun he was to be with.
Funny, kind, with a touch of craziness about him.
Smart, savvy, cool, up for a laugh, never took life too seriously. I mean, in some ways he was a big guy anyway, but he was in some ways larger than life. That was Ray. That was the Ray I knew and loved. We had been to the opening of a Tom Hackett installation in Lincoln. He was sat in that chair, he was having a pint. I said to him, have you enjoyed today, Ray? And he was having difficulty processing language at that point, but he sort of got it out of himself, and it was almost the last thing he said to me, happy. God bless you. Ray.
Here's to Stoops.
What do I do when my love is away?
Does it worry you to be alone?
No, no. How do I feel at the end of the day?
Are you sad 'cause you're on your own?
I tell you, don't you say it no more.